Since we already have a pretty good idea about what limits are in an intuitive sense, we're going to now take a look at the Heaviside function, and in doing so, we're going to take another look at limits in detail, particularly left-sided and right-sided limits. So the Heaviside function looks like this right over here. Now, what's interesting about this function is that when the x, or in this case we call it n, when the n is less than 0, then the y value will be 0. But as soon as the n is equal to 0 or greater, which we can see from the graph right here, then the value for y will be equal to 1. So a good example of a Heaviside function would be a switch, where 0 is the point, and x of 0 would be the point where it would maybe be representing a light that goes from off to on, 0 to 1, so to speak. Now, as we look at the Heaviside function, let's consider what the limit would be as it approaches, as x approaches 0, particularly starting from the left side. So we don't have a table, but we know for a fact that all values going towards 0, right over here, all values going towards 0 will have the value of 0 for y. And so we know that it seems like, for now, that the limit as x approaches 0 will be equal to 0. But the problem here now is that when you look at it from the right side, all values going towards an x of 0, this way, from the positive direction, seems to be yielding a value of 1 for y. That would make it seem as if the limit is 1 as opposed to 0. So the question is, what do we say when somebody says, find me the limit for this function as x approaches 0? Well, the answer to that would be just write does not exist. And the reason why is that when we talk about x approaching 0, this is something we went through in the last video, but we're going to go through in detail this time. What we're actually saying is, as x approaches 0, specifically from both the left and the right side. Now, from the left side, it seemed to be approaching 0, and from the right side, it seemed to be approaching 1. And because it seems to be approaching two different numbers, you can see that, again, the x is going this way, and the x is going this way. When it's going from the left to the right towards 0, it seems to be approaching 0. When it's going from the right to the left, approaching 0 for x, it seems to be approaching 1. So when it's approaching two different numbers, based on if you're starting from the left side looking towards the right, or if you're starting from the right side looking towards the left, then you can say for a fact that this limit in general does not exist. However, you cannot say that the limit does not exist as it pertains to only the left side or only the right side. So what do I mean by that? Well, what I mean by that is this. You can actually write, and if you remember the limit notation, you can actually write the entire limit notation so long as you write this small negative sign right over here to denote that the limit from the left, so for the limit from all the x values starting from lower than 0. Graphically, it would be all the x values starting from lower than 0, basically only in this one direction, the left-sided limit, is equal to 0. You can also refer to the right-sided limit, so the limits starting from all the x values above 0, so basically only the ones looking from this direction towards 0. You can actually say that the limit for that would be equal to 1. So basically what we just learned is, in the first video, we talked about x approaching 0 overall, in general, which implies both left and right. But now we learned that you can actually break them into specific pieces. For example, the limit as x approaches 0 from the left, or the limit as x approaches 0 from the right. Awesome. And in detail, if you can summarize what we just said, if the limit from the left does not equal the limit from the right, then we can say that the limit overall does not exist. Now, if the limit from the left did equal the limit from the right, then you can say that the limit does exist. More specifically, if, let's say, the number that the limit equals is, I'm going to use a variable b, then if the limit on the left equals b, and the limit on the right equals the same number, b, then we can say not only that the limit overall exists, but we can even specify that the limit overall is equal to b. Now that we learned a little bit about one-sided limits, limits from the left, from the right, and what it would mean when limits from the left and the right either equal each other or do not equal each other, let's try a few questions together. So, example one says, find the limit as x approaches negative 2. Now, to answer this question, why don't we look at all of the options? So, it says in option A that the limit is negative 2. It seems like maybe this answer seems to be alluding to this negative 2 on the x-axis, which has nothing to do with the y-value that is being approached. Remember, the limit looks at the y-value that's being approached. So, I mean, this negative 2 has nothing to do with us. So definitely A is not the answer. B says 2. I mean, if we were looking at the right-sided limit, every x value going this way as x approaches negative 2 from the right, then B could have been the answer, but we're certainly not looking only at the right side. So B is not the answer. C says 4. So this could be the answer if we were looking from the x values on the left side. But again, the question never said left side or right side, which automatically implies both left and right. So the only option left is the fact that the limit does not exist, and this is definitely the case. In fact, if we want to go into detail, we can say that the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the left for this function, which I will just call f of x for now. In fact, why don't we just label it f of x for this entire function, is equal to 4. Now, we could also say that the limit as x approaches negative 2 from the right for this function is equal to 2. And like we said earlier, when we're approaching the same number but from different directions and the limit does not equal each other, then definitely that limit overall does not exist. If they do equal each other, then whatever number we find over here would be our answer if somebody asked us, what is the limit as x approaches negative 2 overall? In this case, once again, since the left-sided limit does not equal the right-sided limit, we cannot say that there actually is a limit as x approaches negative 2 overall. So D is our answer. So in example 2, we have, based on the following clues, does the limit exist for the function f of x as x approaches 4? So there are two clues, and with this, you should be able to say if the limit exists or does not exist. What do you think? All right, so for a limit to exist, as we said earlier, if the left-sided limit is equal to the right-sided limit, then we can say that the limit exists. If we look at the first point over here, what it's saying is that for the function f of x, the limit, the y value that's being approached as x approaches 4, and notice that negative sign, from the left side is equal to 5. If you look at the second point here, we basically said the same thing, only we're saying that from the right side, you see that positive sign. So the limit as x approaches 4 from the right side for the function f of x is also equal to 5. And what do you know? The left side and the right side equals each other. So what can we say in general? We can say that the limit as x approaches 4 for the function f of x. And notice how we don't have a negative or positive sign here. What that means is, once again, both sides equal to 5. So not only can we say that the limit does exist, we could have also even said more specifically that the limit exists and the limit is equal to 5. So this is our answer. Now let's try our final question together. It says, based on the following graph, does the limit exist for the function g of x as x approaches negative 2.5? What would you say? Well, we can see that we're looking at an x approaching negative 2.5. There are no directions attached to this phrase. So we're not talking about left side only or right side only. We're definitely talking about both sides. When we consider x approaching negative 2.5 from the left side, you can see that we are getting closer and closer to, and unfortunately, this is not labeled. But it doesn't need to be labeled, because you can see that it's getting closer and closer to the same number on the right side for the right-sided limit. So the left-sided limit is going to be equal to the right-sided limit, because you can see that they're approaching the same unfilled dot. Whether it could have been filled, it would have still been approaching the same limit, but in this case it's not filled. And it didn't need to be labeled. Maybe that was, I don't know, let's say 2. Or maybe the graph could have said a, just to keep it as a variable. But you would not actually need to even know what the y value is, because you know one thing for a fact, from the left, as it pertains to an x of 2.5, it is approaching the same dot as from the right approaching 2.5. So it's clearly approaching the same y value, regardless of what that y value is. And since the question was asking, does the limit exist? And not asking us, what is the limit? Give me the value of the limit. We are able to answer this question correctly by saying that, yes, in fact, it does exist. Now, if they asked us, what is the limit? And it happened to actually label that y value right over here as a, then you can indeed say that the limit as x approaches negative 2.5 is equal to a. Now, one thing I do want to make clear, however, is this. If somebody asks you what is f of 2.5, basically when x is 2.5, and this is kind of going back to our previous lesson's material, just to refresh your mind. If somebody asks you what is f of 2.5, what should your answer be? Well, you might be tempted to just say a, because the left side limit and the right side limit seems to be the same number. But remember, limits have nothing to do with what the number is when x is 2.5. Because in this situation, with that empty dot, you must say that f of 2.5 is undefined. And once again, we have highlighted that asking what the y value is when x is 2.5 is not the same as asking what y value seems to be approached when x is approaching 2.5.